Thank you very much, Rami Quintanar. Always nice to have you introduce me. And our Team Crone is back with us. I think it was just proper because Team, remember, ended up running up last year. And I'd just like to ask you, Team, maybe you can give us an idea of how it would feel, the pressure you would feel going into this almost the same situation that you had last year.
Yeah, we're very, very similar to what Shell went through. And because we were, you know, we were there. Pure Fruits had a two-game winning streak against us, and it was the first time since long begotten that anybody was going to come back on a two-game deficit. And it's the same thing. It's never been done for Ginebra as well. I mean, for anybody to go back from a three games to one deficit. And I tell you, the pressure is immense. I think the pressure is more on Shell right now. And even though they came out strong in the first half, they were, both teams were kind of going back and forth, doing nothing at first.
Well, starting five, I was kicked out of a rookie by the name of Pallad, no? Did that surprise your team?
Yeah, it surprised me very much. Here in a championship game, game seven, and you go out and start a rookie. And that took a lot of guts by Sonny, and we came out and did a really good job. He picked up a couple of early fouls, but he got a couple of free throws, and it kind of set the tone. That the thing that got me about that starting lineup, it was very small, and it was very quick, and I think Sonny felt that in the last few games, Shell's gotten off by getting a running game going, and Sonny wanted to stop that right off the bat and did a good job.
A good start here for Shell in the last few minutes of the first quarter. Took an 11-point lead in the second quarter, but they lost it, team. Not because McSanok was out, or we can say that Leo Austria really played his part very well. What do you account this?
Well, I think that as they went on, I think that in the early part of the game, I thought Travis Cole was trying a little bit too hard, and they never was looking at him, looking for him too much. And in the second quarter, they started moving the ball a little bit more around, and Sonny got involved a little bit more. And Shell had a hard time, you know, concentrating on Jervis inside. They had to go out and extend their defense a little bit, and that caused some problems.
Well, of course, Sonny hit also 5 points all from the outside, so that certainly helped Jervis call on the inside because it became unreadable on what they were going to do. No? Okay, team, and I will just take a little break. We'll come back in a couple of minutes and talk more about the possibilities here in the second half, so please stay with us.